Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to create a Windows 10 bootable USB flash drive with the media creation tool. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to create a Windows 10 bootable USB flash drive with the Microsoft media creation tool, the first thing that you'll need is a USB flash drive that's at least 8 gigs in size. And it would be best if this is a blank USB flash drive or just any flash drive that you don't have any important files on and that you don't mind formatting. Once you've got that, you can plug it into your computer and then you can go ahead and open up a browser on your computer and you can do a Google search for download Windows 10. The best match should be the download Windows 10 ISO file webpage from Microsoft. Make sure it's from Microsoft, then open that webpage. And if you scroll all the way down on this page, you'll find the section that says Create Windows 10 Installation Media. Go ahead and click on Download Tool Now. And that's going to download the media creation tool for Windows 10. Once it's done, just click on Open File. It's going to launch this Windows 10 setup wizard. Next, just accept the terms. Then next, you'll get these two options where you can upgrade this PC now, the PC that you're currently using, or you can create installation media. Now you need to select that option to create installation media. Select that, then click on next. And then you can choose between these options. And if you want to change them, just uncheck this box. Then you can change the language to what you want. The edition will stay the same, which will be Windows 10. But you can choose between 32-bit, 64-bit, or you can download both in one ISO file. I'm just going to select 64-bit because that's what most of us will be using. But if you're going to be installing Windows 10 on the same PC that you're using to create this bootable USB flash drive, you can just leave this option checked to use the recommended options for this PC. Then you can click on next. You'll be prompted if you want to create a USB flash drive or if you just want to download the ISO file. For this video, we're going to be creating a bootable USB flash drive, so we'll leave that option selected. Then click on next. Now you need to select a USB flash drive that you want to use. And I suggest that you just plug one singular USB flash drive into your computer, the one that you want to use to create this bootable USB flash drive. It's just going to make it easier and so that you don't get confused with different USB flash drives. So I only have one option, so I'm going to select that and then click on next. Now first it's going to download the Windows 10 ISO file, and then once it's finished, it's going to create that Windows 10 bootable USB flash drive. And you'll just have to have some patience with this because it might take 10 to 20 minutes depending on your internet speed and if you're using a USB 3.0 flash drive or not. Once the entire process is finished, you're going to see this window that says your USB flash drive is ready, and then you can just click on finish and then it should close this Windows 10 setup wizard. And if you go ahead and open a file explorer window on your computer and then navigate to this PC, you should see the flash drive labeled as ESD-USB, and if you open that, you should see all of these files on that USB flash drive. Now to boot from this USB flash drive, you'll need to restart your computer and then select this USB flash drive as the boot device. Now, once you can select the boot device, you'll see that the USB flash drive shows two boot options. You'll have the normal legacy BIOS option that you can boot from, which is the one that I'm currently on now. And then you'll also have this UEFI option that you can choose. Now, it is quite important which one you select here. Basically, if you have a new computer, you'll be using the UEFI option. But if you have an old computer, you'll be using the normal boot option. And also, when you use the normal legacy boot option, the drive that you're installing Windows on will need to be using the MBR partition scheme. And if you use the UEFI boot option, the drive will need to use the GPT partition scheme. But I've got separate guides on my channel showing you step by step how you can install Windows 10 or Windows 11 on your computer. And I'm going to link those on the screen now, and you can go ahead and watch that if you need any help installing Windows on your computer. But I hope this guide has been useful. Please like the video, and I'll talk to you guys soon.